it took a little while for me to really decide, make that decision, that, well, I'm going to fill out the application kind of thing. And it really wasn't until I was working here at KSC that happened. And it was after a few years of working here at KSC when people that I consider to be mentors encouraged me to do it. Once they knew I was interested in it all, they encouraged me to do it. And I honestly think without that, I would never have even picked up the pen and filled out the application. I really don't, because I didn't feel like there was anything special about what I had done. And especially after seeing, the people around me that were in the astronaut office, or even people that were working here at KSC with me, I'm like, how do I stand out at all? So I'm very thankful, because what cooler place to fly than space, which is what, led me down the whole path to wanting to work for NASA, to begin with. But I'm very thankful to the people that, maybe knew a little bit more about me or saw something in me that I didn't necessarily, see in myself. In preparing to fly, the training for a space station flight especially is a lot of time out of the country. So over 50% of my time for about 3 years before my first flight was in Russia or Japan or Europe or Canada. So a lot of back and forth, a month here, a month there. The biggest challenge is how do you manage, kind of that balance of family and getting ready to fly in space or flying in space. And I think the key to that is, like it would be with any balancing work and family, is just keeping them engaged as much as possible and making them feel like, they're part of the training and the mission too. And that was what worked best for me, I think, in overcoming that challenge, which I think overall has been the biggest one. For my own self, from looking out the windows of the station and looking at Earth, looking out into space and seeing kind of this depth to the stars and kind of that connection that you get to that, the word awesome just totally applies. I really believe I have a better understanding of the definition of the word awe because of it all. It's one of those things that I wish, anybody that wanted to do it could do it. If it was just for 5 minutes, could get up there and have that view and have that feeling of, how your body adjusts to something like that. Our bodies and our brains are pretty amazing things, and the way that they just take the signals that they're being given and, deal with the different environment. And we're doing some really cool stuff with the, the exercise equipment we have and some of the studies going on to figure out how do we kind of counter that. So since we know we're coming back to gravity, that we'll be ready to do that too. The international relationships we've developed and, kind of overcoming the challenge to build something that complex in space with 15, 16 different countries involved, and the positive relationships that we've developed from doing that have benefited us here on Earth in, many ways as well. I think we, because of those relationships, deal with our international partners on other issues in a much more positive way. I also think that the station is this perfect example of getting a dual benefit out of something. Everything about it, the science that's going on, the way the space station works, the solar arrays for generating electricity, the systems that clean our air, all of that kind of self-contained thing, every aspect of it is helping life get better here on Earth and helping us figure out how to explore further off our planet, get further out of low Earth orbit. The parallels are perfect. And after flying in space, I think back on it and I look and I try to find what was that the one best training experience I had in preparation for what it would be like to live on the space station and living in Aquarius with, and it's 60 feet underwater, was in this habitat that was like the size of a school bus, was the perfect analog to that. If you combine what was done with the history of the space shuttle, with what we did with Apollo and the programs before that, there really is this like wealth of knowledge for how we live in space, how we assemble things in space, how we do science in space. I don't think you could look for any better example of of preparation for future spaceflight. And certainly the lessons that we learned, over time and how you manage a program like that. The things that you need to do to keep yourself safe and then allow yourself to prosper are just represented very well by what went on with the Space Shuttle program. And I'll tell you what, you couldn't look for a better group of people to assemble and care for and feed spacecraft than you have here at Kennedy Space Center. The expertise that's here is amazing, and I hope for that future we'll be taking advantage of that expertise as well.